Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I am feeling particularly trusting that you will not judge me for being crazy for the angle that I'm going to take on today's demo. The demo? Google Calendar mobile versions, iOS and Android, which are now identical apps. Let's take a look at them. The angle. You know, calendars are boring things if you think about it. You put in an appointment, you recall that appointment later. Bah, it's boring. But it strikes me that every year at Christmas time, people exchange beautiful calendars with each other. They want their calendars to look like artwork. They're things we look at a lot. So they add photos, they add seasonal context to what's going on in the calendar, which we typically don't have on our computer. Well, Google has done a couple of things with their mobile version of the calendar, one of which is they've made it seamlessly integrate with the desktop version, look the same, and they've made it very accessible. That is a good thing. But the thing that I find really interesting is they've made a way for the calendar to be more interesting, to be richer, to make it feel like you're more engaged in life if you use Google Calendar. You think I'm crazy right now. I know you do, but I'm not. Stick around and I'll show you why today on Dotto Tech. As I said, Google has now standardized the Google Calendar app on iPhone and Android. It looks identical in both worlds. I'm going to start things off today on my iPhone 6 Plus, and then I will also show you some of this demo on my Android, on my Samsung Galaxy Note Edge phone, so that you can see that it looks the exact same in both. And as far as I can see, with one small exception, all of the functionality is the exact same as well. So kudos to Google for making the app the same in all the different platforms. So when you launch the Google Calendar on your smartphone, of course, it's going to sync to your Google Calendar, to your existing Google Calendar. And for a long time, Google has been my calendar of choice. One of the beauties of the Google Calendar is that I can use it as a base and I can sync other tools to it. For example, I use Sunrise Calendar, which has always been really the strongest of the mobile versions of the calendar apps. I've synced it to the database within the Google Calendar for a long time, and it's great from that perspective. And a nice thing about this, actually, this whole thing is, you don't have to, if you like Google Calendar on the iPhone, you can switch back and forth between it and other calendar apps, and it's easier and more elegant than, say, doing with email apps. There's nowhere near, you're not storing as much data. So you can actually switch horses mid-race occasionally if you want, with no harm done. Having said all of that, we take a look here at Google Calendar, and when we first open it up, we see it's got a very clean and very functional interface, which calendar should have. I mean, we need access to the basic information. But I will dress this up for you in just a few moments. The functionality is identical to on the desktop. If we tap on the left-hand side in the top, we can come up with our different views and decide exactly which calendars we are going to be looking at, turn on and off calendars, and each one that we turn on will have different color-coded additions. If I turn on holidays and birthdays, you see when I go back that now all of a sudden I've got all these green holidays and birthdays that have been added. So you can turn on and off calendars to your heart's delight, depending on which calendars you've subscribed to on your desktop version, so you can gain access to more or less information if you need it. That is all very good. As far as the view goes, you can view your day at a time, or you can view it by a 3-day or a week view that they have here on the smartphone, on the iPhone. On the Android phone, they have a month view. I haven't found it on the iPhone, so that's the one big difference that I've noticed. But I don't like any of those views. This is the view I like. It's called a schedule view. And all it does is shows appointments stacked on appointments. So you can look, and if you've got a lot of appointments in a day, the day will seem very long. And if you've got no appointments in the day, there'll be no entries at all. I like this interface. I find it tremendously functional and easy to use. So that's how this is actually, of all of the different calendar interfaces that I've looked at, I think this is the cleanest and I like this one the best. Now, one of the things that we do a lot with our calendars is we add appointments. And this is where I'm going to start to show you what I was talking about at the beginning, how Google is making it more engaging and in a way making our calendar and our lives a little more beautiful. So let's add an appointment. And to do that, we tap on the plus button in the bottom and you start typing in an event. And I'm going to type in lunch. Let's say I'm booking a lunch with my good buddy Bosco Anthony. So I say a lunch meeting. As I start typing in the word lunch meeting, up comes the option to create lunch meeting. So they have pre-fills And what Google is recognizing is typically if you're putting in a lunch meeting, it's going to be at a location and it's going to be with somebody. So look, they're asking me a question. Where is it at? And so I can just start typing in the name of the location. So let's meet at my, there's a really nice botanical garden that's got a wonderful little restaurant. It's called Van Dusen here in Vancouver. And as I start to type that in, look, up comes the address. So I put in Van Dusen Botanical Gardens. Now what it does is it will populate into the appointment the address and the location of the restaurant that we're going to be meeting at. So as I'm going to it, if I've forgotten the location or if I've forgotten where it was or if I don't know where it is, especially when I share this appointment with Bosco, you can use the directions in order to get there. You can use the built-in location services and GPS. So it pre-populates that information so you don't have to type it in. And again, it'll look to our calendar to add people. And I'm going to put in on my good buddy Bosco. And all ready to go. Watch what happens when I say done. I love this. We say done. And it saves it. And you look at the bottom of the event. You can see what it's done is it's pulled the header image from the Van Dusen Botanical Gardens mobile site, and it's plugged it in to the calendar appointment. So it's kind of dressed up the appointment. But the best part is, when we look at it now in the screen, when we look at it in the view, it's done the same thing. So all of a sudden, instead of just having a list of events, I've got a list of events with some supporting graphics. Now, if it's a plain, simple lunch appointment, it doesn't have a location, it'll just put a plate and a knife there, but it still looks that much better. I really, really like this. Now, when I look at my day, it's not just a series of appointments, but it becomes a series of events, a series of connections, because it's adding these different graphical elements. I don't want to overstate it. It's not life-changing, but it makes me feel better looking at it. And it's causing me to look long and hard at using Google Calendar and my smartphone an awful lot more than I'm using the other calendar apps, just because I like looking at the appointments. Plus, it works. It's very, very, very functional. Now, how about it in the Android world, Steve? You promised that you'd show it to us in Android? Let me show you the same thing in the Android. If I take a look at the Android version, now this is on my Samsung Galaxy or my Samsung Note Edge smartphone, we can see that it's got the exact same view. All of the different selections are the same. Here's the one additional selection point that you have, is you can view a month at a time, which actually isn't horrible, but it looks way too claustrophobic for me. So instead, we choose the same scheduling level and all of the same features, the same way of entering information, the same way of viewing information. It's now the same in both iOS and Android. So for me, the native Google Calendar might be my first recommendation for people to take a look at. If you need some other sophisticated services like we've shown in Sunrise, you might look at some other solutions. But as I say, one of the best parts of it is that you can use multiple calendar apps without kind of polluting the water, because it's not quite the same as using multiple email apps where you have to download the email into the app each time. Multiple calendar apps works fine, as far as I'm concerned, at least. So give it a shot. Take a look at the new Google Calendar. And if you're like me, you'll probably really enjoy how it dresses up your day and makes every day seem like an event rather than just a series of responsibilities. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Now remember, there are three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please, please subscribe to this channel. Secondly, subscribe to our newsletter, and then you'll hear about all of our upcoming live events and webinars and courses. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site supported by you, the viewers of the channel. If you drop by our Patreon page, you'll understand what is involved in supporting Dotto Tech and what benefits are included, because we have some perks and personally, I think the perks are awesome. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.